Bismillah Rahman Rahim, rounding a flat curve. Sports car is rounding a flat curve and the curve is unbanked. The radius of the curve is R. The coefficient of static friction between road and tires is mu s, that is given. And we have to find the maximum speed at which the driver can take the curve without sliding. In order to take a turn around the curved road, radial force is required. When the radial force is present, then there should be the radial acceleration. When the body is moving in accelerated motion, Newton's second law of motion will be applied. First is to identify the problem, and we have identified that Newton's second law of motion will be applied, and the target variable is the maximum speed at which the car can take a turn. Second step is setup. First we have to draw the sketch. This is the sketch of the problem. Next we have to draw the free body diagram of the car. We place a dot for this car, and one force is the gravitational force, and it is acting downward. This is the weight of the car, W is equal to mg. Other force is the normal reaction of the road, that is in upward direction, and this normal reaction is n. And the third force is the radial force, which is toward the center of the circle, and frictional force is providing the necessary radial force in order to take a turn. And acceleration of this car is toward the radial force. We will attach set of coordinate axes, x-axis along the direction of radial force and y-axis perpendicular to it. Third step is to execute the problem, and we will apply the Newton's second law of motion, sigma fx is equal to ma radial. There is a single force acting along x-axis, that is the frictional force F. This net force is producing the radial acceleration in the car. Sigma f is equal to small f is equal to m a radial. A radial mean radial acceleration, and the equation of radial acceleration is v square over r. So f is equal to m v square over r. Or if the velocity becomes maximum, then frictional force will also become maximum. Then applying Newton's second law along y-axis, sigma fy is equal to ma radial. Since a radial along y-axis is 0 because there is no motion along vertical direction, so a radial is equal to 0, so sigma fy is equal to 0. Net forces along y-axis is the normal reaction in y direction and weight in y dash direction. Therefore, n minus mg or n minus w is equal to 0, or n minus mg is equal to 0, or n is equal to mg. Next, we know that fs maximum is equal to mu sn. Putting the value of n is equal to mg, we get f maximum is equal to mu s mg, or f maximum is equal to mu s mg. We have to find the value of v maximum. So putting the value of f maximum as mv maximum square over r is equal to mu s md, and simplifying this equation, we will get the value of v maximum square is equal to mu s gr. Here the maximum velocity depends upon mu s, coefficient of static friction. If mu s changes, value of maximum velocity will also change. And second factor is r. And if we change the R, the maximum speed at which the car can take a turn can be changed. We are given the value of mu s as 0.96 and value of R as 230 meter. After putting the value of mu s, G and R, we get the value of V maximum as 47 meter per second, or 170 km per hour, or 100 miles per hour. Next step is to evaluate maximum speed depends upon the value of mu s and r. If the road is wet, or IC, then the value of mu s will be changed. In this case, maximum speed will be reduced. Maximum speed at which a car can safely take a turn will not be equal to 47 meter per second. And if we want to increase the value of maximum speed, then we have to increase the value of r. Then we can increase the value of velocity during taking a turn. If the car speed is faster than v maximum, then the car will skid away. If the speed of the car is less than v maximum, then it can safely take a turn. So our valuation is correct. Thank you very much for watching this video.